Hey guys, welcome to DevTech Finance. In this video, we would be covering the topic expected loss. This video is a part of credit management module, so I recommend you to watch other related videos to this. So starting with introduction, what exactly expected loss is? It was introduced under the IRB approach of calculating risk under Basel Norms 2. So basically, Basel norms were introduced for better risk management in banks and financial institutions, for maintaining adequate capital and for making provisions for any risk related to the loan assets. So all these things, Basel norms were introduced. And under Basel norms 2, expected loss, the concept of expected loss came in, which was under IRB approach, that is internal rating based approach. Now there were two approaches, standardized and IRB approach. So here in IRB approach, the banks used to provide, do their own internal assessment and give risk weightage to different kinds of loans. And thus they calculated overall expected loss. However, in standardized approach, it was external rating on the basis of the rating given by credit rating agencies. They used to calculate the expected loss. So moving on to next point, let's see. This is based on bank's internal assessment of risk-weighted assets and the probability of default risk. As I already mentioned that expected loss was introduced under IRB approach, where banks used to do their internal assessment and then assign risk weightage to different loans. So different loans are not having same kind of risk of default. There are secured loans, there are unsecured loans. Now secured loans are less riskier as compared to unsecured loans, because unsecured loans are given without any security or collateral. In the same way, we can classify as short-term loan and long-term loan. So long-term loan are more riskier, so risk weightage given to them would be higher side as compared to shorter term loans, because for longer duration, the time duration involved, there is higher chances of being default from the side of borrower. Thus, the risk assessment could differ depending on the type of loan and other factors. Now, expected loss thus signifies the total loss that the bank or lending institution could incur due to default by the borrower. So exactly by all this concept, we are trying to say that expected loss is total loss that any bank or any lending institution, which could be any financial institution, could incur if the borrower defaults. So we have given loan, and if borrower does not repay the loan, there is a default risk involved. So what would be the total loss that the bank would incur? That is calculated as expected loss. Now moving on, here you can understand like expected loss is a product of loss given default, probability of default and exposure at default. So one by one, we would be looking what exactly probability of default is, loss given default is, and exposure at default is. So expected loss is, as I said, product of all three. So EL is equal to PD into LGD into EAD, where EL is representing expected loss, PD is probability of default, LGD is loss given default, and EAD is exposure at default. Now let's see what all this means. Expected loss. It is product function of all three, as I already mentioned. Probability of default. It measures the likelihood that the borrower will default on loan repayment. So here we are trying to calculate the probability or chances, that what are the chances that the borrower would default on the loan which has been given. So this chance could range from 0% to 100%. Now it would depend on various factors like the credit history of the borrower. So what has been the credit history, the past loan behavior, whether the borrower was making timely loan repayments or not, all these factors, the economic condition, how the economic condition is going on, if the economy is going in consistent slowdown, so the probability of default would be higher because the borrower would lose his repayment capacity and the industry performance. So the business in which the borrower is involved, how that industry is performing. So if that industry is collapsing, the borrower, the chances that the borrower would default would be higher because he won't be reaping benefits out of his business. And thus we could assign what should be the probability depending on these factors to any particular borrower. Now, loss given default. What exactly is loss given default? So it is the loss amount after deducting the value of collateral and amount recovered. So we have given loan of 5 lakh rupees, and there is collateral, which is any kind of asset put as security or guarantee, which is amounting to rupees 2 lakh. So left is 3 lakh. In case the borrower defaults, we are already having the possession of that collateral, the possession of that security. So we are having the asset amount of 2 lakh. Rest is 3 lakh rupees, which is the loss given default for us. And if any amount has been recovered out of that, so maybe the borrower has paid certain installments, so we have already recovered 1 lakh rupees. Left is only 2 lakh. So that would be our loss given default. So exactly loss amount which is left after deducting the value of security and the amount that has been repaid by the borrower. Next is exposure at default. So exposure at default simply is the total amount of loan that has been provided to the borrower by the lender or the bank. So it is the total amount of loan because it is having the full exposure which can be at default. So thus this name comes in, exposure at default. So the point to remember, expected loss is equal to probability of default into loss given default into exposure at default. Now let's understand this with one numerical example. So here's an example. So let's say company XYZ takes any business term loan from bank ABC. Now the loan amount is about 50 lakh rupees and the collateral, which is security or guarantee as an asset, which has been pledged, is about 20 lakh rupees. So what is the expected loss if probability of default is 90%? So on the basis of the internal assessment, the bank has given the probability of default, which is about 90%. And since it is a business term loan, which is a longer term loan, the probability of default is on higher side. So let's see how this can be solved. So here, exposure at default is our loan amount, which is 50 lakh rupees. The probability of default assigned by bank is 90% or 0.90. Now, what would be loss given default? So as I mentioned, loss given default is after you deduct the amount that has been recovered. So 1 minus recovery rate. Now, recovery rate would be your collateral placed, because that is the security amount which you are having as possession with you, divided by the total loan amount, that is 50 lakhs. So 0.4 is recovery rate. Now 1 minus 0.4 here is 0.60, or we can say 60%. So 60% is loss given default. Now what would be our expected loss? We are having probability of default, loss given default, and exposure at default. So we can calculate EL as by doing product of all three. So 0.90 into 0.60 into 50 lakh, which is coming to 27 lakh. So here in this case, where the loan amount given is 50 lakh, the expected loss is 27 lakh after deducting the collateral amount and taking into consideration what could be the default probability. So thank you. This was all for this video. I hope you liked the video. Do like and share. Subscribe to my channel, Dev Tech Finance. Thank you all.